Hey, R2. Everything looks pretty good over there. Oh, wait, our friends are here. Just one moment. Hey, everyone, and welcome to Groove Builders, the show where we create together. I'm your host, Disorderly Cone, and just one moment. Okay, R2, here comes the water, but this time, make sure it doesn't overflow. There. Okay, now see you on the workbench. R2 and I are trying to make sure we have enough water inside of our bay, because today we're going to be adding the Nautilus from 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea to our collection. And Groove Builders, I'm pretty excited to add this, because not only is this known for being one of the trickier models to build out there, but it's also for one of my favorite adventure movies of all time. Groovers, let's get down to the workbench and take a look at the package together. Groove Builders, welcome to the workbench. We have the Nautilus from Genius Technologies here, and this thing looks so awesome, Groove Builders. Look at that sub. Now, on the bottom here, we have a QR code which we can scan to get a 360 view of our submarine if we need it while we're building. This is very useful for looking at the different parts of detail and how they go onto our ship. Now, on the right-hand side here, we have a star rating, which tells us 3 out of 5 stars. This is about a medium difficulty, but these ratings should really only be taken with a grain of salt. Let's go ahead and take a look at the back. On the back, we get a nice look at our metal, and on the right-hand side here, we have some instructions on how to build our model. But we're going to go into more detail about that during our build. Groove Builders, let's go ahead and open up our package. We have our instructions, and we have our metal, and look at that. All nice and wrapped up, but look at the detail. That is unreal. Groovers, let's get this open and get building. With our metal in one hand and our tools in another, we begin to cut out our first couple of pieces for the infamous Nautilus. And Groove Builders, I can't tell you how nice it is to be holding one of these pieces of metal in my hand again. Yes, I love painting, and of course, I do like those wooden models and 5D paintings, but at the end of the day, I absolutely love these metal models, even though they do have a very big difference in metal quality. Like Genius Technologies here, their metal is very nice, it's pretty thick, and also the detail is very well done on most of their models. However, some other models out there from a lot of other companies, especially some knockoff companies, you'll find their metal to be very brittle and really super thin, making it almost impossible to build the different models you're trying to do. But like I said, you're not necessarily going to find that with Genius Technologies. Although, I do have some issues with this model, but we're going to get into that a little bit later. So now, Groove Builders, I think we've come to the part of the show where we have to ask ourselves, what do we need to build the most scientifically advanced submarine of all time? That's a good question, and I think that we have some instructions and a droid that might be able to help us out with that. R2? Thanks, buddy. Starting at the top, we have that QR code again, followed by a nice depiction of our Nautilus. Then, just below and to the left, we have a picture of one of our parts. Here, we get to see what our tabs, insertion holes, and fold lines look like. It's very important to understand this picture before moving on, because it's the basics of metal model building. In a nutshell, you want to form all of your pieces along the fold lines, and then, once everything's built, you want to connect your pieces together using the tabs and insertion holes. Now, how do you secure them together? That's a great question, and it's answered right next door with our circles and triangles. These two symbols are scattered throughout all of our instructions, and with good reason, because they tell us what to do with our tabs. When we find a circle, you want to grab as much of the tab in your tweezers as possible and then bend it down 90 degrees, as flush as possible with that part. When we see our triangles, you want to grab as much of that tab in your tweezers as possible and then twist it 90 degrees. Now, Groovers, I can't stress the importance of making sure that you grab as much of the tab as possible in your tweezers. If you don't, you will have some loose parts on your model, which can definitely take away from the end product. Now, just below our circles and triangles, we have our tool section, which here they only recommend 2 tools, needle-nose pliers, and some scissors to help you cut out your pieces. Groove Builders, both of these tools are very useful for helping you build this build, but I would also recommend some other tools which aren't listed here, like a very good pair of tweezers, strong tweezers, ones that are not going to bend when you're trying to bend metal around it. Now, I'm only being specific about these tweezers because a lot of the times I find with some of these kits we'll receive in the mail, they'll send us some tools, and these tools are oftentimes not up to par with building the metal model that you're building. So Groove Builders, if you've gotten some tweezers at home from a kit, just double check them to make sure that they're not weak. If they're weak, just take them, throw them out, and find some better ones around your house. With the Nautilus, we do have four different domes to bend. Now, you don't have to use a tool to, of course, help you shape these, but it does make life a lot easier. But because of the size of these domes, really the only thing that will fit inside them is a small ball bearing. And as most of us don't keep ball bearings around our home, you might find yourself forming these with tweezers. Don't worry. Just make sure you take your time and line up all the pedals as you go. If you do, you should have a pretty well-shaped dome. Oftentimes in my videos, you'll see me using some white tools to help me shape all of my domes and cylinders. These tools are known as a doming set, and they're very useful for shaping these kinds of parts. However, they're not a necessity for building 3D metal models. They're just very useful to have. Then finally, at the bottom of our page, we have a schematic drawing of our sheet of metal, which is very useful for helping us find our parts. Now, Groove Builders, throughout all of our instructions, you'll see numbers associated with each step. Those numbers associate with parts from this metal sheet, and you'll need to retrieve them from the metal sheet in order to build the sub. Pretty straightforward, right? But sometimes it can be a little bit confusing, and that's why I recommend, once you've taken the part out of the metal, go ahead and take a black marker and just mark out that number. It will make it a lot easier for you to find future parts as you go. And with that, we're finished with our instructions. So I guess the only question that remains is, where is the Nautilus from? The Nautilus is a submarine from the famous book, then movie, 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. The stories follow Captain Nemo and his crew as they pilot the highly advanced Nautilus around the world. The sub was built in complete secrecy by Nemo and his crew for two main reasons. One, to satisfy human scientific thirst for knowledge, and two, to reap revenge on the slave and government ships. The Nautilus is electrically powered and can perform some pretty advanced research underwater, as well as take down enemy ships with a ramming attack, often leaving no survivors. But there were one or two, leading many people to believe that a monster was attacking all of their ships. Pretty good cover, if you ask me.
Oh, wow! R2 and K9 did a fantastic job capturing the inside of the Nautilus. I mean, just look at this place, it's great. And not to mention, our Nautilus came out looking pretty good too, although it definitely was tricky. Let's talk about what it took to build this Nautilus in construction. My first point when it comes to building the Nautilus is about the detail that goes on either side of these bubble windows. Groove Builders, the pieces here are incredibly small, and when you're forming them, they're very easy to break, so make sure you take your time when doing this step. You don't want to break any pieces on our Nautilus, because getting replacement parts can be a little bit tricky. My second point is about this tail right here on the Nautilus. It's also a little bit tricky to build, especially because everything's already together. Now, Groovers, make sure you take your time with this spot. I actually had to take my tabs and directly feed them into the hole just to get them in their place. Now, if you find yourself getting a little bit frustrated, just stop. The last thing you want to do is break this on the last step. And for my third and final point, I want to talk about making sure that all of our pieces are nice and clean before we put them together. With this particular build and a lot of other metal builds, if you don't make sure that all of your pieces are nice and clean, that means making sure that all of the excess metal's cut off, you'll find that the pieces don't go together that well. And at the very end, your bottle might look really sloppy. So Groove Builders, make sure that all of your pieces are very clean before putting them together. You'll thank yourself in the end. And with that being said, Groove Builders, let's move on to build time. The Nautilus from Genius Technologies took me just over 4.5 hours to build, allowing me to be able to watch 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea almost twice before finishing. Now, Groove Builders, that time is about average, I think, for most people out there, but you can definitely take longer, especially with this back area and the tail. That is where the majority of my time was spent at the very end, and definitely the cause for majority of my frustration. But again, Groove Builders, it's never a race, so make sure you take your time. You'll thank yourself in the end. And finally, group builders, my thoughts. Ah, the infamous Nautilus, definitely one of my favorite submarines of all time. And group builders, I think that the guys over at Genesis Technologies did a pretty good job representing the Nautilus. Although I will say there are some very big cosmetic things on here that kind of take away from the overall model, especially on the front here. It's missing that iconic shape that we all know the Nautilus to have. Now, I know a lot of people out there will make the comment that yes, the movie had its own description of the Nautilus, but I think that the movie version is actually probably one of the better descriptions of the Nautilus from what I've seen, and I really wish they would have tried to capture that here a little bit better. But I digress. Group builders, if you really do like the Nautilus, you're going to be really happy with this particular model. Now, if you're new into metal model building, there are some difficult parts on here. Not too many, but that tail here at the end, that's where you're gonna get a little hung up, I think. That part can be very difficult, and I mean this, group builders, take your time with that last little step. The worst part about building these models is getting to one step and just really having a hard time building it and accidentally screwing the whole thing up. With these particular builds, you can't get replacement parts very easily, so make sure you take your time. If you break it, you break it. Alright, group builders, that brings us to the end of our show. I had a really good time building the Nautilus with you, and if you guys are looking to pick one up for yourself, make sure you check out Crazy Toys' website. They got all kinds of really cool 3D metal models on there, and not to mention some pretty fast shipping too. Until next time, group builders, keep building. Alright, Timothy, where are those seaweed cigars? I'm dying to try one!